Great.
Hello, Congressman.
Hey, Juan.
My question would be, what would you say to Republicans and independents who are watching tonight and are contemplating about voting for you, but are worried that should you win, your main objective as senator would be to try and impeach President Trump?
I want to tell everyone in this state, regardless of your party affiliation or any other small difference that does not have to define us at this moment, that we can come together. I want to represent all of you. It's why I'm here in the Rio Grande Valley, one of the most reliably Democratic places in the state, if not the country. We could bank on your vote, take you for granted, but I keep coming back to communities like McAllen because I want to hear your story and I want to incorporate it into our campaign. It's the same reason that I go to Abilene, Texas, one of the most reliably red parts of the country. People joke that as you're orbiting the Earth, you can see it glowing red from outer space. First time we go, maybe 25 folks show up at that town hall meeting. The fourth time we go, we have to hold the town hall meeting in a space like this at the Paramount Theater in downtown Abilene because 800 people have shown up. Republicans, independents, Democrats alike, finding common cause in the big, ambitious goals that we have this country, making sure that in a state where half the teachers work a second job just to make ends meet, that we have their backs, pay them a living wage, they can just focus on one job, that we lead the conversation on immigration, or that we go from being the least insured state in the United States of America, whose number one provider of mental health care services is the county jail, to being a state where we are there by and for one another, leading the way on universal, guaranteed, high-quality health care. That is my focus on the things that we can achieve, and I will work with anyone, anytime, anywhere, including President Trump, whose administration I have worked with to pass legislation to make this country and my community better so that we can advance these goals that we all share regardless of our party affiliation. Thank you for the question. Appreciate it.
Congressman, his question was about impeachment. And you said in July that you would, as a member of the House right now, vote to impeach. Have you changed your mind?
I haven't. Let me put it this way. There may be an open question as to whether the president, then the candidate, sought to collude with the Russian government in 2016. But to quote George Will, very conservative columnist, when we saw him on that stage in Helsinki defending Vladimir Putin, the head of the country that attacked our democracy in 2016, instead of this country and its citizens and this amazing democracy, that was collusion in action. You may have wondered when he fired James Comey, the principal investigator into what happened in that election, whether that was an attempt to obstruct justice. But when, by broad daylight, on Twitter, he asked his Attorney General Jeff Sessions to end the Russia investigation, I would say that's obstruction in action. Ultimately, however, Dana, this is a political question. A Republican colleague of mine in the House will have to come before an audience like this and explain to her constituents or his constituents how they just voted to impeach the president of their own party, how they put their country ahead of their career or their next election or the politics of the moment. The best course to get so that every member has all the facts and that they are compelling enough to do the right thing is to allow the full independence and integrity of the Bob Mueller investigation.
But you've already said, even though that's not done, that you would vote to impeach. And so, according to the Constitution, that means that the president has committed the crime of treason, bribery, or a high crime and misdemeanor. Which one of those do you think the president has committed?
I would liken impeachment to an indictment. There is enough there to proceed with the trial for a full vetting of the facts and to make the best informed decision in the interests of this country and our future. As you know, under the Constitution, as a member of the Senate, it's a far different bar. That is a trial with my colleagues where we look at the facts. And I would not prejudge the outcome of that trial. All I am saying is that there is enough there. And I think I laid out the case in both the collusion with a foreign power and the effort to obstruct justice going forward. I know that this is not politically easy or convenient to talk about, but 242 years into this experiment, which is the exception, not the rule in world history, there's nothing that guarantees us a 243rd or a 244th. It's up to all of us to stand up for that democracy. The best way to do that is to express it on the 22nd of October, the first day of early voting, and then election day on the 6th of November. But yes, to answer your question, I do think there's enough there for impeachment. And if asked, I would vote on it. Now, I have not made this the mission of the campaign. I've never called for it at a rally, never sent a campaign email out about this. I'm not on any articles of impeachment for all the reasons that I just gave you. I'm focused on the future. But yes, I want to answer your question honestly. And I think there's enough there to make sure that we move forward.